Parents, if your kids won't go to sleep, Benadryl works well. But as you can see, we had some fun. We learned. When everybody was in hair nets, that was a mission project this year. They added that in. They made baggies about this big, and we each donated $3.50, which is enough to build a feed an orphan child in Haiti for a week. One little baggie is 6 meals. And it was rice, soy, vitamins, and vegetable flakes. And that reconstituted, that's what they do. And the Change the World, that's the organization that Southern Baptist Convention partnered with to do that, to ship it over there. I don't know if I'm a little box total of how much they sent, I haven't heard that. There's quite a few boxes each week, we're doing this 5 weeks of summer salt. But you've seen a lot of the dark ones at the worship service tonight. You can hardly see it, how lights off and the stage lights go on and that kind of stuff. A lot of when they were sitting around in the courtyard and on sidewalks and in pictures, that was the morning devotions. We had open ceremony, open assembly, and then they had 20 minutes of devotion every morning. So when they were moving around, that's about the time that the devotions were over. And let's see what else we do. They get any of their classes because you don't want to interrupt too much when they're actually in their classes. Overall, I think we had a good week. The title of this year was Twisted, and I'll just briefly tell you what that's about. As you know, in our world, the truth gets twisted easy. We have one person that's going to speak more on that in a little bit, so I won't go into detail. But that was the theme for the week. Some will speak about the different lessons. Some will just speak about the overall experience. There were some decisions made, and I believe that they're going to talk about that a little bit and a little bit about the report.
Amen.
So to get started, we're going to ask you to stand. I'm going to put some words on the screen. And the first one we're going to do is one that we have the worship service with. So y'all join in and sing that. You tell me what you say.
We are here for you.
Morning, everyone. Welcome to Dollar Hill Baptist Church. We have welcome announcements for you. Today is Good Sunday in Mountain Time. Tuesday is visitation of all groups, meetings night, Tuesday, Thursday, youth and care meetings. And Saturday is the all live farm. August 18th, 9 o'clock, food distribution, 7:00. And August 25th, 5 o'clock, coffee free. And the World Hunger Red Letters, inside of holiday, state appropriated village interchange will be led October for the World Hunger Hall.
Those we board had about 5 or 6 of those turned in. As you fill them up, turn them in, and just get you another one. As fast as possible for War Hunger.
Yes, sir, Mr. Gibson.
I'd just like to say a couple words about the things that are coming up. On Saturday, the L.W. Paul Living Farm is an opportunity for the young people here, and young in this case means 50 or under, to see how things used to be done. And the L.W. Paul Farm is the one that's located just beyond the jail on 701 as you're going towards Conway. We need to be there at 8:30. Now, this is a Saturday morning, and so you need not stay out too late on Friday night so you can be able to get up and get over there. We really want all the youth, and that is anybody who's 4 years or more, you know, or they can be less than four, but we want everybody to go. We're going to have the bus here for people that have no other transportation. And there'll be others of us that are going, and we can make sure that everybody has a way to ride. But it's very important for the knowledge of our community and the knowledge of the people that are here. And the older people in this church have a story to tell, and all you have to do is ask. The second thing is that the Cost of Freedom, which is going to be on 5 o'clock, at 5 o'clock on Saturday the 25th, and that's the week after our food distribution, is a very important thing, because those of us in the community here in this church that have served in the armed forces are going to be available to present a program to not only this church, but also to the community about the cost of freedom. They're going to speak about what happened to them when they were in the service, and they're going to speak about what it means to go in the service today. And it's going to be a really moving and emotional time. And we'd like for everyone who comes, young and old, to be here. There's going to be some demonstrations, and there's going to be some participation from many members of this church. And so we're really anxious to have you here at 5 o'clock in the afternoon on the 25th. Thank you.
Well, thank you for letting us and all for you.
But may I remind you, if you get ready to do an offering, we also have a building fund offering. Just let you know that when we do offer, there'll be plenty more. Page 3, we're doing it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, what would a devil want to do to defeat a superhero? Or maybe even trick him, make him look bad, maybe? That's what Batman, right? The Batman, right? Look like that. What? Really great at being awful. No? But, so, like, in Matthew, the devil tries to do that. He tries to beat Jesus when he tries to tempt him. Right? He took him on top of this, on top of the church and said,
Thank you. in Testament, I tell myself keep walking on. Here's something up ahead, waterfalling like a song. In an everlasting stream, your river carries me home. Let it flow, let it flow.
Thank you.
sun forbears to shine.
Right when this guy started preaching on advisory,
life. I mean, this is like a perfect hand. Like the hand of God is touching the most, possibly the one of the most unclean persons ever. And he called them be clean. That is a picture of the gospel right there. Because, I mean, if that, whenever he said, be thou clean, it's nothing to do us. We were like that. We were too damaged. And the fact that Jesus died for every single one of us just astounded me. How can you die for people? I mean, I know not all of us have, like, murdered 60 men or, you know, done, like, stolen everything. We haven't done, like, all these bad things. The fact that you could still die for us, I mean, you lie. I don't know, cheated, stolen, the little things, that's still sin. Lying about somebody is the same thing as stabbing them. I mean, there is no, we weigh sin, there is no way to sin, sin is sin.
Right.
Killing is just as bad as calling you out someone behind their
back. Oh, yes.
So, the fact that he said, be thou clean, that this man is like him forgiving us of everything we've done, he still loves us despite that. And it says in 2 Corinthians 5:21, it says, for he hath made him to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. You realize what this is? We are allowed to go to the most perfect place in the world because this man decided to take all our crap.
Yeah.
Pretty much. And, I mean, really, how, why would he do that? Because he's just that cool. And then in Matthew 11:28, it says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Not only does he forgive us, not only does he allow us to go to the best place ever, which is heaven, he's going to give us rest. We're not going to have to worry about those things anymore. We can move on from it. Which is amazing. And then he goes on, the transformation leads to motivation. And in Luke 5:14-15, he basically told the guy, don't tell anyone about this. It's not time for me to become, you know, known or anything. The guy could hold me. I mean, if that were happening, would you be able to keep a secret? I don't know how that would. You be able to do that? Really? No. He's not going to tell people, and that's what he did. And, I mean, I don't think Jesus got mad. If anything, I think Jesus would have, you know, laughed at a little bit. Because you can't help but smile at this thing happening. And the man being so happy. And that's what we're supposed to do. We have been saved. And we have been transformed. We were desperate, we are transformed, and now we're motivated. We're supposed to do something. What's that? And we basically have a painted picture of the gospel, and now we have to go share. And this motivation is where my decision came from. Basically, he did witness the invitation, and he let anyone that wished to be saved be saved. And that came up, and people were saved, and it was awesome. And then he said, now I have another offer. How many of you led to any type of preacher mission work, stuff like that? And you know, this happened.
Yeah.
And I was just like, oh boy. And he said, okay, when I count to three, if you feel that, you're going to stand up because we want to celebrate the people who are willing to give their lives. So it was like I was sitting there, I'm like, okay, I'm going to slowly stand up and see what's going to happen. So I stood up. And it was pretty awesome because I feel like what I did this morning with the children, I think I can do that for the rest of my life.
Praise God.
Talking to the kids about Jesus, whether I do it for music, talk about it for superheroes, I don't know. I feel like I can do that for the rest of my life. And it was a life-changing experience because I realized that I got saved, but I never served.
Come on, Jen.
See, this is how I think somersaults work for me. First year was, I learned about them, I got situated, I learned about everything. Second year, got saved, started growing. But then it kind of, you know, when you get really guess, but I figured out I want to do that for the rest of my life.
Amen.
So that was a decision I made, and I think that as a church, we could probably, I don't know, do more things for hunger. I have a special place in my heart for people who can't eat regularly. I am not one of the people. I eat regularly. I probably eat too much. I'm not going to